Yeah, hi guys. Today we are going to look at exponential smoothing models for the time series data. Now, this is the formula we may need to use, in which forecasting value and the actual value. So the value will be listed like this. Say 17 week data is available. Units sold out is available. Our primary responsibility is to find out for 18. Here the hyperparameter is k, the value of k, how much you will be considering. Similarly, this is yet another approach in which we are going to use ft and at. This ft is a forecast for period t. At is observed value in period t. That's all. This is observed and forecast value, observed value. That's it. Ft plus 1 is a forecast for time period t plus 1. We want to find out ft plus 1. Here one hyperparameter is available. Alpha is one of the hyperparameter. This value can vary from 0 to 1. This is called smoothing constant. Because of this only, it is called as smoothing constant. 0 to 1, this is the value we can keep changing. This formula you need to understand what is the way we are using. Then we need to understand this. So let us move on to the next understanding of what is a value if you choose zero, extreme values. See, always we need to understand about extreme values. What will happen? If we choose zero, what will happen? If we choose one, what will happen? So that part we need to be clear. That's all. Reflect 1 minute. Very soon. If you look at this data, let us go back and look at the data. Same data. Understand, we need to prepare first for, see how they are trying. Extreme zero, what will happen is, it will not give any factor. No factor is associated. Directly, you will be working on FT and AT if you prefer zero. If you prefer one, what will happen? That the component 1 minus 1, that component will nullify. So it will give short-term effect. If it is 1, it will give short-term effect. If it is 0, it will give long-term effect. So if short-term and long-term effect, you may need to choose the value between 0 to 1, not to be 0, not to be 1. That's all. So 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, etc. up to 0.9. If you wish, you can try with 0.5 onwards. Then 25 different calculations or simulations you need to do if you are trying with 0.5. Because 0 to 1, how many 0.5s are there, you know very well. So that you need to try with this number. Let us assume 0.1 is our alpha value. What is FT and AT? Look at, as per the formula, AT and FT is these two. That's all. One would be 80, one would be FT. Now let us see. Remember 8844. Remember 0.1. Let us look at how they are calculating. Here, look at here. 8844. 1 minus. This is random, not that exact one. They are taking for the week 2 is 88. The actual observation for the week 1. Next, suppose we choose this. Then the forecast for week 3 would be, from that it is a scenario. So the scenario is week 1, week 2 and week 3. So week 1, week 2 is plugged here. 88 and 44 is plugged here. This 1 minus is the formula, 1 minus alpha. Alpha value chosen here is 0.7. This is the forecasted value for week 3, 57.2. Similarly here, week 3 is 60. How you can do week 3, you are substituting here. Just now you are obtaining for week 3 forecast. This you can substitute back. Then 0.7, 1 minus 0.7, 59. So using this formula and the given the data, you can substitute, you can choose FT and you can choose AT and you can choose alpha. That's it. So now let us look into, here one... The important point would simply repeat last period forecast, short term effect, no effect will be there. One would forecast last period's actual demand. So these two will not become zero or one. There will not be no greater prediction in it. So that we need to choose 0.1, 0.9. So this is what tablet computer sale, 0.1 to 0.9 is chosen. Finally, yes, smooth constant for alpha equal to 0.7 provides a lowest error. So the final conclusion is alpha value equal to 0.7. That only gives the better prediction with lesser error. Now let us look at. So this is what unit sold. Week. If you are trying for forecasting for 0.1, you need to start with 88 and 0.44. This is what we tried. 88 and 0.44 only. The simulation I have shown you. So these two you need to try. But we tried with 0.7. 0.7 is the alpha value we have chosen. That is why we got 57. So first week we cannot predict because there is no prior data. So it is replicated. If you look at carefully, all the columns of alpha value, the first two values 88.0 is repeated because no prior guidance, prior series available. Right from this third week only you have prior series. That is where I said 88 is AT, 44 is FT. So these two, that's all. Nothing more. It's a very simplest formula. The previous value, previous to previous value. In simple term we say without the statistics. There is a hyperparameter alpha. This we can oscillate from 0.1 to 0.8. That's it. You need to plug in, evaluate a simple school level mathematics. Then you can understand what is the value available. The moment you obtain the third value, that third value onwards is this will only will guide. First to forget. You will be obtaining third value. This third value will be helping for next value. Next, we don't refer here anything. Only one value we will refer. The next value only for third week calculation we refer these two value. Then fourth week calculation we will refer this previous value and the obtained previous value 80 and 60 and 83, 56, 81, 70, 78, 91, 77. That's it. This one small change you may need to understand where FT is getting changed. For the first third week only, you will be considering these two. In order to predict this, you need to consider this one and this one, first and two. Similarly, you need to predict this, you need to consider this one and this one. This is a subtle change you need to understand, nothing more here. Then alpha value, for this column, alpha value will become same. This all calculated using Excel sheet only. The next column alpha value is 0.2, 0.3, etc., 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9. So next, all the three types of error, MAD, mean absolute error division, mean square error, then mean absolute percentage error. So all the three errors, where it goes minimal, that minimal value is considered as a final result. So this alpha value 0.6, they are choosing as a smoothing constant. How they are choosing the constant is based on the loss function. Lesser the error, they are fixing the smoothing constant. That alpha is ultimately called a smoothing constant. So that alpha decides the error value. So that which constant, which or which value gives the lesser error, that particular constant is termed as smoothing constant. That's it. So 0.6. Now next forecast 0.6. See, look at here. If you plot this, the original line is this actual blue color. The next is forecaster line, this red color. How closely it resembles? Because error is less. If error is less, the resembling would become closer to each other. More or less, this blue line and this pink line takes the similar shape. More or less similar shape. If you try for other alpha value, you would be getting lot of deviations. There would not be any match at all between this blue line and the pink line. What is blue line? Actual data. This is what actual data. Then next is forecasted data. That forecasted data only, this pink line. So that shows which constant is close to the original data or actual data. That selection of constant is said to be exponential smoothing. Hope so you will be getting to know what I am trying to tell. So this is the formula, set formula you need to understand, in which ft is the forecast for period t, at is the observed value in period t, alpha is the constant value. Your objective is to predict ft plus 1 for the time period t plus 1. That's all. So this is what you need to remember. After this all simplification or shuffling, whatever, this is your final formula, or you can use this formula also, whatever. In this calculation, they have chosen this. Although they have given rewritten form, they have chosen 1 minus alpha ft plus this. So then you need to consider this. Then first simulation, look at here, 1 minus alpha this and 0.7 alpha and 44. For very first week 3 alone, 88 and 44 subsequent values of the original data or actual data is helping for prediction or forecasting, 57.2. Whereas fourth week onwards, you should not touch upon the previous original data. This obtained value need to be plugged and the previous data, AT only need to be considered. Previous to previous data only 88 in our colloquial word. We are considering week 1, week 2. Our objective is to predict for week 3. 88 is previous to previous. Previous is 44. Our objective is to predict week 3. Only for first time, we will be considering the first 2 weeks of data. Then we will be predicting like this. Subsequently, fourth week of the data, we should not consider anything. Just the prior data. 60, the third week actual data, the forecasted third week data, these two we need to plug into the formula. This one small transition or change you need to understand. This is for only for the first prediction. After that, subsequently the predicted value will be supporting for the next prediction. 57.52 is plugged into here, then 0.7 into 60. That's all. So these two stuff, if you remember, nothing more. Now we are going for double smoothing. This is exponential, simple exponential smoothing. That XL minor I am not going to explain. Only XL it is given. Now we are going for double smoothing. Double moving average, double exponential smoothing. There are two different concepts. Now we are going for double smoothing. What here we are trying to do is AT plus BTK. The formula has been changed. Linear trend equation, more or less, it is our linear equation. What is linear equation? Your data, lag data, that I forgotten to explain, it was there in that word file, which I addressed for some other workshop. So what is lag data is, if you look at time series data, look at here, you are given only one data. Week 1, unit sold. Then how you will find the linear equation? So in order to find the linear equation, you need to form independent variable and dependent variable. This is not a variable at all. This is the indicator. This is not useful at all, useless for a computation or statistical analysis. So unit sold, you are given only one. How you can find out dependent variable is, you need to create a lag data. What is lag data is, first data is not applicable. You need to shift this data to the next one position. This fellow will go here, this fellow will come here, this fellow will come here, this fellow will. Like that, 1 lag data, 2 lag data, 3 lag data, 4 lag data, etc. Here what is the challenge is, you need to find out which lag data gives the lesser error, lesser RMSE. That is where you will be succeeding, or you would be succeeded with your prediction. So that is what lag data. Hope so you would be understanding. You are given only one. See, you are running a ice cream parlor or umbrella shop, whatever. So what is the thing you will have? Either time-wise sold out, or time-wise profit, or time-wise loss. Either one. Or day-wise loss, day-wise profit, or week-wise profit, week-wise loss, something like that only you will have. So in such a situation, how you will get one more variable? Linear regression you cannot do without one independent, without one dependent. Minimum simple linear regression only I am talking about. Then in that case also you are in need of one more variable. Then how you would be getting that 4 lakh data? What will happen? 4 null values will happen, not available, because you can't shift 4th lag. First lag data, you will not have one value, first value, one excess value will be there that you can discard. Second log data, what will you be doing? You will be shifting 2, then last 2 will be surplus, you will be truncating. That's all. So now let us look into here double exponential smoothing. So this is what double exponential smoothing equation, slightly altered. Look at here, beta at minus at minus 1 plus 1 minus beta. So instead of that alpha, you will be using here beta. So two constants, the estimate of at and bt are obtained from, there are two estimations you are doing. One is at with alpha, one is b and with beta. So two different estimations you are doing. Let us see how these all two estimations are going to be plugged in. So first we need to look at the data, I think. So look at, yeah, here, total tons. This is what the portion of data you are given, 1975. After 1975, you may need to predict the rest, I guess. So now this is the given data. What is the way they are predicting? Look at here, 438. Where is 438? 1 minute. 438 whole prediction figure R square value. Yeah, sorry. How we may need to proceed is more or less linear equation, like we need to proceed. So we need to find out these two constants that need to be plugged in. Then we can have these value substitutions. With that only we can proceed, I guess. 1 minute. Beta place weight A1, B1, A2 minus A1, exponential smoothing. Here there is no XL, only XL minor is given. If it is XL, we can, yeah, see. We see that best values of alpha and beta are these two. Figure 9.7, figure 9.17. Where is this 9.17? We need to go here, that's all, no other game. Yeah, here only we can, year 1980, actual, forecasted, residuals. So this all kind of plug-in software. The moment we plug in, you will be getting these all. If it is Excel, we can do much better. Let me go through, where is the Excel? No more Excel, only Excel minor is available. So using that formula, these all the stuff have been predicted. So very first step is to find out alpha value and beta value that need to be plugged in. Once alpha value, beta value is obtained, we can plug in with the data and we can obtain the rest of the values. This is for final trend line prediction. This is not the actual double smoothing prediction. Look at here, double smoothing prediction is this. So then from there directly they are connecting to the trend line prediction. Trend line prediction finally, bx, what to say, y equal to mx plus c. So mx plus c. So this is c, m into x. So using this, they are trying for a trend line prediction. From the trend line, again, they will be fitting this all. Then the residual error, that based on the residual error, you can either go for RMSE or you can go for R square, the best fit prediction value. This R square is for best fit prediction. So 0.95, this is pretty good. Always R square need to be towards 1, 0 to 1. RMSE is the matrices always to be towards 0. This also 0 to 1, this also 0 to 1, R square also. So then they take decision which RMSE is good and whether that need to be retained or not. That decision will be taken. Subsequently, trend line comes to the picture. Forecasting time series with the seasonality. So seasonality, what is the meaning? It will be going through in the uptrend up to the month February. All of a sudden it will come down. So this is seasonality for the March month. This is what seasonality. So with this seasonality changes, how we are going to predict? Regression based seasonal forecasting model, next. So look at here, this is the equation. How many months you are using, that many months are going to become your independent variables. These all. Finally, you want to find out gas usage for the entire year. So February month, March month, April month, the entire year, you wanted to understand the gas consumption or usage. For that, we may need to go for analysis. Look at here, gas usage. This is what time, maybe time first 24 hours, that is indication. So this may be the time indication, the entire day throughout the day. Then February to December, every month gas utilization. Using this all data, we are in the position to predict this gas usage. This is a numerical prediction. So this month-wise analysis gives this gas usage. So using this, what they can do is they can understand the demand. So which month people are using more, the supply-demand cycle can be predicted. There may be many more applications or many more uses. The moment you step into this trend line, we are going back to our original, linear regression, where we started this entire subject. For every month, the coefficient. Then from the coefficient, you can form the linear equation. From the linear equation, it is possible. Intercept is also given. Coefficient is also given. You can plug in the values. Then it is possible to find out for any month. For the next year also, you can substitute and plug in these coefficients. You can predict something. So ultimately, the purpose is to predict the numerical value, which is unseen. Gone back. What happens? All of a sudden gone. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am, now it's visible.
Yeah. So this is what you will be doing again. What these all becomes your independent variables. From the independent variable, you can calculate the gas usage. So gas usage, this is original. Then naturally you need to find out the residual or the discrepancies. So the residual value, degrees of freedom, R square, standard error, adjusted R square. So R square is 0.7, adjusted R square is 0.9. It's pretty good. Adjusted R square is best for model comparison. R square is naturally, we can understand, both are too high. So it is above 9, almost near 1, 0.97. This is 0.94. I can say this is almost 1. So it is the better way of prediction happened. So with that, we can stop today for the discussion. So only three topic we discussed. Exponential smoothing, double exponential smoothing, then regression based forecasting for natural gas usage. That's all.